Okay, next we are having the one more design problem based on the codebook IS456 and the SPN 16 chart. Okay, the problem I am reading here. Okay, design a column 4 meter long, restrained in position and direction at both ends to carry an axial load of 1600 kilonewton. Use M20 grade of concrete and Fe415 grade of steel. This is the condition they are given in the problem. Design a column 4 meters length. That means your size of column is having a length of 4 meters and restrained in position. That means in at both ends and both at top and bottom is restrained, that is fixed. And the direction at both ends to carry an axial load of 1600 kilonewton. What is the column available here? The design, what you are designing the problem for this column, what you are designing here, you should to carry a load of 1600 kilonewton and use M20 grade of concrete and Fe415 grade steel. For this column you are designing, you should have to use the grade of concrete as M20 grade of concrete and grade of steel as Fe415 grade steel. Okay, the given parameters I am writing here, the given parameters. Okay, coming to the given parameters, the length of the column given in the problem itself, it has 4 meters and axial load acting on the column equal to 1600 kilonewton load is acting on the column in the axial direction. Characteristic compression strength of the concrete FCK equal to 20 newton per mm square. Yield strength of the steel FY equal to 415 newton per mm square. And the factor load or ultimate load acting on the column, we are having the load acting on the axial column into with respect to the partial safety factor. The axial load acting on the column, we are having 1600 into partial safety factor. We are taking this partial safety factor value as 1.50 under limit state of collapse under compression. Okay, by taking this factor load, we are getting the ultimate load acting on the column. It has 2400 kilonewton. Coming to this effective length, we are having the theoretical value as well as we are having the designed value. When both ends are restrained in that condition, the effective length of the column, we are taking it as 0.65 times of the length of the column given in the problem, where the effective length L effective equal to 0.65 into length of the column, we are having 4 meters. This is the designed value. We are taking that value from IS456-2000. That is the designed effective length of the column. We are taking it as 2.60 meters. Next, for this design of column or design of compression members, we should have to check whether the column is short column or long column, as well as what is the minimum eccentricity, what is the minimum moment carrying capacity, as well as the percentage of the reinforcement provided in the concrete. That is in column, whether it resists the movement or not, that we should have to check. Coming to the step number 2, in step number 2, we are having slenderness ratios of the column. Slenderness ratio of the column. Before calculating in this slenderness ratio of the columns, we are assuming percentage of steel in the concrete. How much amount of percentage of steel you are providing in the concrete column, that we should have to calculate. What I am assuming means, I am assuming the percentage of the steel reinforcement in the concrete. Before assuming that particular value, if you come to here, where AC is the area of the concrete and AZ is the cross sectional area of the concrete, ASC is the percentage of reinforcement of steel in the concrete. In the grass area, what you are taking, suppose this is your column. In this column, you are having some width and depth. In the depth and width and length, how much reinforcement you are providing and how much concrete you are providing, that area we should have to calculate. Here we are assuming that the percentage of the steel reinforcement in the column, it is 1% of the AG, where 1% is the 0.01 value. It is where AG is the gross area of the concrete member. The gross area, how much width you are providing and how much length you are depth you are providing, based on that, the in that depth we are taking the 1% of the steel reinforcement. From this, the area of the steel reinforcement in the compression equal to 1% of AG, that is 1/100, that equal to 0.01 times of AG. Okay, next, the area of the concrete we are getting equal to total concrete area minus
deducting the percentage of the steel reinforcement. The percentage of the steel reinforcement, we are assumed that 1% of the gross area. Hence why total cross sectional area, total cross sectional area, gross area of the concrete minus remaining occupying percentage of the steel reinforcement. The remaining occupying percentage of the steel reinforcement we are having ASC. That ASC value we are assumed that 1% of AG. Hence why area of the concrete only AC equal to area of the cross section AG minus 0.01 times of the total cross section area of the concrete. From this, the area of the concrete AC equal to 0.99 times of total concrete gross area. In gross area, how much width you are keeping in that 0.99, if you multiply, you will get the area of the concrete in the sectional members. Next, we are having the load carrying capacity of the column based on the percentage of the steel reinforcement as well as the grade of the concrete. The load carrying capacity for axial direction PU equal to 0.4 into FCK into AC plus 0.67 into FY into ASC. Where this PU factored ultimate load, already they are given in the problem. Normal load they are given in the problem. We calculated the factor load. This PU factor load equal to 2400 into 10 power 3. This is in kilonewton. We are converting it into newtons. The 2400 into 10 power 3 equal to 0.40 into FCK is the characteristic compression strength of the concrete. AC is the area of the concrete, that is 0.99 times of the cross sectional area plus 0.67 times of yield strength of the steel into 0.01 times of the gross area of the concrete. By substituting these parameters, we are getting the area of the gross area of the concrete. We are getting it as 224.29 into 10 power 3 mm square, 10 power 3 mm square. This is the total cross sectional area of the concrete member. We know area of the column, since it is the square column. In square column, we are having the side by side. It will be equal to square root of the cross sectional area. If you want to calculate the some width, or if you want to assume the some width, then you can calculate the one side area of the column. The area of the column we are having for square column, it will be equal to A square. Where A square equal to cross sectional area, we are having AG. By substituting the one side of the area, for one side of the square column, we are having, for side of the square column, A equal to square root of AG. By substituting this square root of 224.9 into 10 power 3 area of the gross area of the concrete, we are having the one side of the column size as 473.59 mm. We are taking this value as 500 mm. We are taking this value as 500 mm. Hence, provide size of the column as 500 mm by 500 mm. That means width of the column to the depth of the column, we are assuming this value as 500 mm by 500 mm. In this cross-sectional area, we are providing 1% of the steel reinforcement. 500 by 500, we will get to 25 into 10 power 4. In that 1%, we are using the steel reinforcement. After taking off all these conditions, next we are calculating the check for slenderness ratio of the column. That means whether the column is within the less than 12 or greater than 12. If the column is less than 12, then it will be short column. If the column is greater than 12, LEA effective length to the lateral dimension will be greater than 12, then it will be the long column. And here LEX by D or LEY by B equal to less than equal to 12, where L is the effective length of the column, where B is the cross sectional width of the beam. That means the effective length, we are having 0.65 times of the effective length of the column, that 2600 divided by 500, which is getting, we are having 5.2, whichever is less than the 12. That means the column, we are assuming it as, we are taking it as the short column. While short column is there, for this again we should have to calculate the minimum eccentricity, minimum moment carrying capacity, based on the minimum moment and minimum moment carrying capacity, how based on the interaction curve, whether the provided area of the reinforcement, it will be satisfying the applied moment or not, that we should have to calculate. Up to now, this is the thing. Next, we will calculate the minimum eccentricity and minimum eccentricity and the allowable maximum moment carrying capacity of the section.
Okay.